this is Lovely Lovebird Designs. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to make a horse pony pencil hugger on the rainbow loom. This one I made with purple and white bands and a pink bandana and pink bow. And this one I made with a fuchsia bandana and it's brown and white. And I also have a hobby horse tutorial, and you can see the difference muzzles you can use too. This one I didn't add any white on the muzzle, so it was all one color with black mane, and this one was a red bandana, and I made a black horse with the white on the mane and a purple bandana. So there's different variations that you can make. So if you like hobby horses, you can check out my hobby horse tutorial. And this one, I'll be showing you how to make the pencil hugger section first. And then we're going to make the muzzle and the head. And then finally, we'll make the bandana also at the end and connect everything together. And I want to just say the hugger part is around 38 bands. The head is around 39. The mane, I just use a handful of rubber bands because we use it by hand. We'll put that in by hand with the hook. And the bow is around 3 bands. And the bandana, around 15. So let's get started. And I'm going to make a black horse with a white muzzle, a white hair, and purple bow. And I'm going to use this black, white pattern. If you don't want to use this pattern, you can make it all black, or you can make a white horse at any color you'd like. Okay, let's get started. You'll need a rainbow loom, and I'm going to take out the middle section. We're just making the pencil hugger section first. Okay, I'm going to keep it just like that, and I'm going to do white and black, and you can use whatever colors you'd like. So, I'm going to take my white first, and I'm going to twist it. These are all singles. Twist it and place it on the loom just like that. Then I'm going to take another white, and the first layer are 5 bands. So another white, twist it, and place it on the loom. Another white, twist it, place it on the loom just as so. Okay, another white, and we're going to place it on this band going on diagonal. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we're going to do another one right here, 5. Okay, and twist. And now my next layer will be black, and I'm going to place it right on the top. Then I'm going to place another black, and we're just going in a pattern, just right around. Okay, and we're just going on the same pattern. Okay, now we can start looping, and we're going to see the white on the bottom, and we're going to just grab the white and place it over, and now we're going to grab this white, place it over, keeping the black. Now we're going to grab this white, it over in the same pattern. Just grab all the whites. Okay, now push it down. Now we have the black on the bottom. I'm going to do another white layer. And it's the same pattern. We're just going right around. Okay. color you have. Okay, you can see that. Now I'm going to make around 7 layers of this, and it's going to bring me to this length. If you want to make it longer, you can make it longer, and you can see it growing within the loom, and you can make it the whole length of the pencil, or even shorter if you like it just on the top. But I think 7 layers is really nice for this type of course. So I'll push it down. And now we're going to go to black layer. So it doesn't really matter like which pen you start on, because it all just goes into the middle anyway. Okay, so now we're going to grab the white layer. And now another white layer. Okay, now we're going to grab the black layer. Down. Okay, another black layer. Okay, now we're going to grab the white layer and bring it over. Okay, let's count how many layers we have. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let's go to another layer of white. So if you want to make it longer, you can make it longer too, because it'll all end up the same at the end. I'm going to attach everything to 3 rubber bands at the end to attach it to the head. Okay, so now we're going to grab the black. Okay, so now I have my 7 layers. I'm going to grab 3 black bands, place it to the side. I'm going to take my hook and slowly take these off the loom. Start with this pin first and just place them on my hook. Okay, and then finally this one. So now I have all 5 bands on the hook. I'm going to take my 3 bands here and then slowly slide them on here. So now this is your pencil hugger part. If you want it longer, you can still go and make it longer or keep it like this. gonna bring back my loom, place the center pin bar straight down. It's gonna be a straight configuration. I'm going to place this on one of the pins so we don't lose that. This is gonna stay right there. And now we can work on the muzzle. If you want the muzzle to be just one solid color, you can do that. But if not, I'm gonna make white on the top and then black on the sides. So we can get started with that. Okay, I'm gonna grab two whites. And if you don't want a white muzzle, remember, you can just make it one color. So I'm gonna grab two whites here. Two whites here. Then another set of two whites, double white. Okay, now we're going into black. So a double black. Okay, and then another double black. And I'm going to take a black and wrap it around four times. This is a single black. Two, three, and four. Then I'm going to take a single white, twist it upon itself, and place it on these two pins. Then I'm going to take another single white, twist it, and place it on these two pins. And now we can start looping. And I'm going to loop this band first. Then this one. Okay, and we're going to loop forward with the white. Then another white on the diagonal, and the last white. Now I want to make the top part of the muzzle black, so I'm going to take a double black and just take your hook. We're not making a slip knot with this one. Just bring the double black through. Now you can take it off the loom. And this is your muzzle. And once we put it on the horse, it's going to look like this. So once again, I'm going to put it right here for safety on one of the pins. And now we can start looping the head. And also you can, whatever color eye color you want, you can pick out what eye color you want now too. I'm going to pick out blue for my eye color. Okay, we're going to make the ears, which is a double black wrapped around the hook three times. Then you take another double black and place that right on that double black. Place it on the hook just as so. That's one ear. Then you take another double black and place it on your loom. And still a straight configuration, arrows pointing down. Okay, that's one ear. Okay, we'll do the second. Here's another double black, wrap three times around. Another double, and place that on the other double so it looks bad. And then another double to be placed on the loom. Okay, so now we can work on the head. And it's going to be another double black. They're all double blacks. Then on the diagonal, going to this pin. So it's 1, 2, 3, fourth pin down. Okay, and then we're going to work in the middle now. Okay, so we're going this pin to this pin, another double, and then another one just like that. So now we're going to take this one, nothing's going to be here right now, the muzzle will be there, but we're going to place the hugger part, we'll take that off the loom, and we're going to push these pins down, and place the hugger part right here, this triple band. Okay, now we can place the muzzle. I'm going to take it off the loom. And we have the capping band here and the two bands on the top. We're going to place the two bands on the top on this pin and the capping right here. So first I'm going to do the capping band. And you just place it right on this pin. So there's a lot of bands on this pin. So be careful with that so nothing breaks. Then we're going to place this double black right here on this pin. So now we can start looping. Well, we also put some eyes. So I have glitter blue eyes. You can use whatever color you like. I'm going to wrap it around the hook 6 times. You can also use beads. Okay, and then I'm going to use another. Okay, so I have 2 eyes right there. I'm going to take a black band and place the eyes on the band. Okay, here's one. And number 2. So you can put the bands around so it looks more like a ball. Okay, and we're going to place it on this pin, this side, and this pin right here, and separate the eyes. So now we can start looping. So now it's very thick on the bottom here. I have this as the top band, it's higher than this band. So I'm going to go right through and find, you can pull this out, which makes it easier. Find this band. Pull it through and put it on the hook. Keep the muzzle in the middle. Now I'm going to grab this band. It should be the bottom band. Okay, and that was the hard part. It wasn't really that hard. So now we're going to loop the middle forward. The muzzle's already coming out. So now I'm going to loop this side, the right side. And now the left. Okay, so I'm going to use the color of my hair will be white, but you can use any other color you want for the mane. So, and even in this brown one, I have a black hair. So I'm going to use the color of the mane hair that I want, and I'm going to grab 3 bands. Place my hook through. And I'm going to make a slip knot. Just like that. Okay, I'm going to take it off the loom slowly. Try to keep the muzzle in the front, because sometimes when you take this off the loom, it'll hide in the back. But we want to keep that in the front. Pull that muzzle out. So now we have our horse. We're going to pull that muzzle out, pull the eyes. Okay, pull the ears up, make them pointy. Kind of looks like a zebra, he's super cute. Now we're going to add the white hair in the back, the mane. So I just really grab a handful of bands and I do slip knots in the back. And at the end, you can keep them like this, or I like to cut them, and it's like this. Okay, so I mean, I usually take 2 to 3 bands. Well, no, 3 to 4. Make it a little bit more fluffy. And I just grab bands in the back. Any bands. And I place the bands like this and just make little knots, little slip knots, and pull taut, and you have some mane already. So I'm just going to grab 4 more and you can make it as thick as you want or as thin as you want. It's your desire. That's why I just grab a handful of bands. So I want some more on the top, so I'm just going to grab some in the back. So I'm going to grab some more because I want more fuller. I like this part because you can put your own touch to it. Okay, I want it a little bit more fuller in the back, so I'm going to just grab a little bit more. he looks pretty cute this way. So you can keep him or her curly hair like this, but I'm going to snip this one. So you just take a scissor and snip the end of the bands. Okay, make sure you don't snip the horse or else it'll fall apart. Just the end of the mane. And you can keep it curly too. Okay, so he looks pretty cool. And if you want to keep him like this, you can keep him like this. And or you can add a bandana. And I'm going to make a bandana for you right now. I'm going to make a purple bandana. Okay, for the bandana, you need around 15 bands. And they're all single. You can use whatever color you'd like. So I'm going to use a single purple band. Place it on the loom just so that we're going to make the triangle part first. And then wrap, and then the wraparound part. So one, two, three, and one on the diagonal. Then we're going to go to the next, and one, two, another diagonal, another one going down, and then it's another one wrapped four times around. Okay, and we can start looping these. First one, then we're going to grab this diagonal, then we're looping the right side forward. Now we're going to grab this diagonal and finally this one. So we're going to keep this on the loom right now. And we're going to flip this sideways, and we're going to get six bands and place them down the loom. So one, two, three, four, five, and number six. Okay, then we're going to take another single, wrap it around four times at the end. And then we're going to take these three from before off the loom, keep it on your hook. So one, two, and three. Okay, this is your triangle part. Now we're going to place it on. One, two, three. The third pin, we're going to take the first set of bands off. So it'll be these set. It'll be two bands. Right here, the first set. And we're just placing it right there. So there was three over here, placing the first one here, second one here, and the third there. So here's my second and my third. Okay, so it just looks like that. And now we're going to loop forward to connect everything together. Looping forward. Now we're not grabbing these bands. We're just grabbing the bottom bands that we placed first. Okay, now we're going to take another purple and we're going to make a slip knot. Just like that, and then we can take it off of them. Okay, you don't need the loom anymore. Now you have a little bandana for your horse. And stretch it out, and you have a triangle with the neck part right here. So now we can take the horse that we made before, and you can put it around the neck. And what I like to do is I place my hook right through this capping band, and then I pull this through so it makes it a little tight, just like that. Okay, so you can put the bandana in the front or in the back or in the side, and you can leave this loose like this, or you can just tuck it within the bandana and hide it, just like that. And if you want a little bow, like this one, I'll teach you really fast. It's very simple. You just take two bands. I use two, you can use four, you can make it as big as you want. Place it on your fingers, just as so. Then you're going to make a knot with this one around. So I'm going to grab this right in the middle, make a little slip knot. Like that, and you have a little bow for the top of her head. Okay, just like that. You can put as many bands as you want with that, or different colors. And then I just take this and I wrap it around itself, and then the hair in the front, I can wrap it around a couple times and you make a little bow, a little hair tie. And she's super cute. And then you can place it on your pencil. And it can also be a finger puppet too. Put your finger in there and have a little puppet. And you have a really cute little horse pencil topper. I hope you like this tutorial. Please subscribe to Lovely Lovebird Designs. And we'll see you soon. Thank you. Bye-bye. Hello, this is Lovely Lovebird Designs. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to make a horse pony pencil hugger on the rainbow loom. This one I made with purple and white bands and a pink bandana and pink bow. And this one I made with a fuchsia bandana, and it's brown and white. And I also have a hobby horse tutorial, and you can see the different muzzles you can use too. This one I didn't add any white on the muzzle, so it was all one color with black mane. And this one was a red bandana, and I made a black horse with the white on the mane and a purple bandana. So there's different variations that you can make. So if you like hobby horses, you can check out my hobby horse tutorial. And this one I'll be showing you how to make the pencil hugger section first, and then we're going to make the muzzle and the head, and then finally we'll make the bandana also at the end and connect everything together. And I want to just say the hugger part is around 38 bands. The head is around 39. The mane, I just use a handful of rubber bands because we use it by hand. We'll put that in by hand with the hook. And the bow is around 3 bands, and the bandana around 15. So let's get started. And I'm going to make a black horse with a white muzzle, a white hair, and purple bow. And I'm going to use this black, white pattern. If you don't want to use this pattern, you can make it all black, or you can make a white horse and white on the bottom. And we're going to just grab the white and place it over. And now we're going to grab this white, place it over, keeping the black. Now we're going to grab this white, place it over, in the same pattern, just grab all the whites. Okay, now push it down. Now we have the black on the bottom, and we're going to do another white layer. And it's the same pattern, we're just going right around. Okay. And one more. Now we're grabbing the black, whatever the color you have. You can see that. Now I'm going to make around 7 layers of this, and it's going to bring me to this length. If you want to make it longer, you can make it longer, and you can see it growing within the loom, and you can make it the whole length of the pencil, or even shorter if you like it just on the top. I think 7 layers is really nice for this type of horse. So we'll push it down. And now we're going to go to black layer. So it doesn't really matter like which pen you start on, because it all just goes into the middle anyway. Okay, so now we're going to grab the white layer. And now another white layer. Okay, now we're going to grab the black layer. Push down. Okay, another black layer. Okay, now we're going to grab the white layer and bring it over. Okay, let's count how many layers we have. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let's go to another layer of white. So if you want to make it longer, you can make it longer too, because it'll all end up the same at the end. I'm going to attach everything to 3 rubber bands at the end to attach it to the head. Okay, so now we're going to grab the black. Okay, so now I have my 7 layers. I'm going to grab 3 black bands, place it to the side. I'm going to take my hook and slowly take these off the loom. Start with this pin first and just place them on my hook. Okay, and then finally this one. So now I have all 5 bands on the hook. I'm going to take my 3 bands here and then slowly slide them on here. So now this is your pencil hugger part. If you want it longer, you can still go and make it longer or keep it like this. Now I'm going to bring back my loom, place the center pin bar straight down. It's going to be a straight configuration on any color you'd like. Okay, let's get started. You'll need a rainbow loom, and I'm going to take out the middle section. We're just making the pencil hugger section first. Okay, I'm going to keep it just like that. And I'm going to do white and black, and you can use whatever colors you'd like. So, I'm going to take my white first, and I'm going to twist it. These are all singles. Twist it and place it on the loom just like that. Then I'm going to take another white, and the first layer are 5 bands. So another white, twist it, and place it on the loom. Another white, twist it, and place it on the loom just as so. Okay, another white, and we're going to place it on this band going on diagonal. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we're going to do another one right here. 5. Okay, and twist. Okay, now my next layer will be black. And I'm going to place it right on the top. Then I'm going to place another black, and we're just going in a pattern, just right around. Okay, and we're just going on the same pattern. Okay, now we can start looping, and you're going to see the